Praise God. I welcome you this morning for our daily encounter. And today we are dealing with the topic of the fallen motivation. Let's pray. We thank you, dear Lord, because you have made this day that we may rejoice in you and be glad. You minister unto our hearts, our mind, and our souls, and open our spiritual eyes that we may be able to face every battle that comes our way. In Jesus' name we pray. We are dealing with the rules of engagement, and when we ask ourselves, what are the rules of engagement? Who are we engaging in this battle? And our job is clearly spelled out and cut out for us, and it comes from Ephesians 6, from verse 10, and it says, finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's scheme. For our struggle is not against the flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the power of the darkness, and against the spiritual forces of the evil in the heavenly realms. We are being told that our engagement is between two people or two powers. We are engaged with the Lord on one side and the forces of darkness on the other side. The devil has refused to obey the Lord, and he wants the man as the one who was given all the dominion over the earth also to be disobedient to the Lord. And that is why he comes with an idea that is so deceptive that it appears as if it has no harm at all. And that is why we see the fall of man in Genesis 3. And it says, now the serpent was more crafty and than any other wild animal and the Lord, that the Lord has had made. He said to the woman, did God really say to you, you must not eat any tree in the garden? He first of all asked a question to put the doubt in human beings, in human minds, by asking, did God say you should not eat? It puts the doubt. Why is he bringing this innocently? And he also goes on to tell the woman, if you eat, you will have the power of knowledge of good and evil. It seems a very innocent thing just to have the knowledge of good and evil. But what he was aiming for is to make the mankind to be disobedient to God, to make his own decision, not to depend on the Lord for decision making, not to depend on the Lord for guidance. Because the moment you know the good and evil, you start making your own rules. And that's the first battle that was waged against the human being put against God's authority. Because once the man ate the fruit, he broke the commandment and challenged God's authority. Now he was aware of good and evil. He could make his own decisions. And that is when the Lord appeared to them. They hid because they said they were naked. They already had already made their own rules that they are naked and they ought to hide from the Lord, to hide their nakedness. Nobody told them. They lived that way for long. But now they had challenged the authority of the Almighty Lord. And that is why they felt naked. So the serpent came in innocently and told the woman to choose between the tree of life and the tree of knowledge. And since then, we have inherited that disobedience. And we have used three main things to disobey God. The first thing is knowledge. When people acquire knowledge, they want to rely on the knowledge. And that is why the scientists are challenging the order of creation by coming up with a theory they call Big Bang and others, so that they don't go with the creation order by which God gave. They want to use their knowledge to their advantage. But the knowledge they have come up with, knowledge comes from a word, scientia, or science. But this science hasn't helped mankind in any way. If anything, it has created more harm than good. We try to solve all our problems with knowledge and wisdom and understanding than science. But if you see some of the most devastating diseases like AIDS, they are said to be manufactured by mankind. The war that are being fought is due to the knowledge of man. Even the issue of COVID-19 is still a matter of discussion because it was an animal virus that could not be transmitted to man, but it was modified in a lab, and now it's affecting the man. Our knowledge has brought us to war with God because serpent brought knowledge innocently, but now it has divided us from the principles and the rules of God. We want to use our knowledge to our advantage. The second thing that we are using as mankind to disobey God is religion. Many are the people and the religious leaders of this world that have devised laws that govern the mankind. Many are the time the religions don't want to subject to the rule or leadership of God by obeying Jesus Christ and confessing that he is Lord and King over their lives. There are many religions. There is Muslim, there is Hindus, there is Buddhist, and even some of the Christians, they don't believe in salvation because they want to obey the rules they made themselves in their religious practices to put God aside and refuse the grace that they were given freely through Jesus Christ. They are using it. Some are good preachers, some are good religious leaders. But the moment you tell them to receive the salvation through grace, which is free, then the strong man in them comes out. They oppose it completely, and they don't want to hear about the grace anymore. The other thing is amassing of wealth. We are competing against one another, against one nation to the other. The Chinese are competing with the Americans. The Americans are competing with the Russians. Who will amass more wealth and power? But we are told that the war is not against flesh and blood. It's not against your fellow human, human to human. It's against the spiritual forces, the evil spiritual forces in the heavenly realms, the principles, the powers of the deceiver or the enemy who is the devil. That is the main war that we have to engage. But we are engaging against war with one another. The issue of accumulating wealth. When we are wealthy or rich, we feel we are above others and we don't belong to their class. And even sometimes we feel that we have sufficient, that we don't need God anymore in our lives. We feel we can sustain ourselves. We think our wealth is enough for every need we have, that God is secondary. And that is why in Western nations, the religion is dying off because they have amassed a lot of wealth and their children are thinking they have everything they need and God is just secondary. He is not a primary thing in their life. He should stay away and they don't care whether they worship him or not. There is a Bible verse, there is a young man in the Bible who accumulated a lot of wealth. And he told his soul, now settle down. We are going to eat and make merry. Because he thought, I have everything I ever wanted. And the soul should not struggle anymore. Should not strive to go out anymore to look for anything. He was self-sufficient in his knowledge and understanding that everything he had needed, he had filled all the stores, he had no more room. And he decided it's time to sit. And he told the soul, now we can relax and eat. But that same time, the Lord told him, your soul will be with me. Because God gave us dominion and he gave us free will to what we do with our body. But the soul belongs to him, whether evil or righteous. And when we agree with the soul to do what is not commanded by the Lord takes what belongs to him. And when the soul was taken, the man and his wealth, they were no more. Because you are dead. The wealth you have accumulated won't help you anymore. It's no longer important. And we forget that as long as we have the breath we have, it's the soul that God gave unto us, the breath that he breathed unto us, that is more important than the flesh that we see, than the wealth that we see. This war is not against flesh and blood. It's against the powers, the principality, the forces of evil in the heavenly realm. If we can engage them, we will win the battle. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Alleluia.